Miss.
Yes?
Tag-asa ka.
Tag-asa pa! Haven't seen before. This is me, Melanie, saying, keep watching, keep slaying, and keep fighting.
Kahit alam mong hindi na ikaw ang mahal niya.
And you do not, the liar is my pick.
Cause Showtime is not the only one that can do the...
Storya natin ngayon ay pinamagatang
Once upon a time, there was a man named Edward Chase Tolman. He is an American psychologist who developed a system of psychology known as purposive or molar behaviorism, which attempts to explore the entire action of the total organism. He proposed the purposive behaviorism, a link between behaviorism and cognitive theory. Tolman believes that learning is a cognitive process. Learning involves forming beliefs and obtaining knowledge about the environment, and revealing the knowledge through purposeful and goal-directed behavior.
There was a very fine, fabulous, sexy, young, and hot vlogger that wants to explore the theory of Edward Tolman.
She wanted to ask some students in Ascot about purposive behaviorism. She wanted to know if they knew something about Edward Tolman's theory.
How do we know that learning has occurred?
Change in behavior. Is equals to learning.
Can learning occur without a change in behavior? Can learning happen and intentionally not be evidenced? Can learning happen without reinforcement? Kabalugo ko sa answer. May kabalugos? Magandang buhay sa umaga,
ayon at magkwentuhan. Magandang buhay. Magandang buhay.
Never reinforce.
Magandang buhay ba?
Okay, all of you, I want you to go to the library to search the purposive behaviorism, and the timer starts now!
I'm so tired!
Yeah, it's so init. Look at my skin, it's so gray na! Oh! Tala,
yung pa sa library.
Always reinforce.
Okay, all of you, I want you to go to the library to search the purposive behaviorism, and the timer starts now.
You just need to.
Okay.
We're wrong. The other way is the right one. Come in. See?
3, reinforced only after almost an hour of finding.
Okay, all of you, I want you to go to the library to search the purposive behaviorism, and the timer starts now!
Purposive and goal-directed. An organism learns by pursuing science to a goal.
Solomon concluded that learning can happen possibly even without us knowing it. This learning that occurred has just not been evidenced yet. There's been no motivation for, in this case, the students to show that they knew the exact location. When reinforcement was finally presented, they quickly showed that they had been learning as evidenced by the abrupt increase in performance. Solomon called this latent learning.
Nap, let's watch TV.
Okay, fine.
Wow! Amazing!
The parents are surprised that on the first time that their daughter holds the remote control, she already knows which buttons to press for what function. Through latent learning, the child knew the skills beforehand, even though she has never done them before. From this latent learning theory, he also found intervening variables. These were variables that could not be observed but can directly or indirectly affect learning. Hunger was an intervening variable on the students. He showed that these variables were the actual determinants of a behavior. The students were learning during the passing of lots of minutes, almost an hour, even if there was no reinforcement to evidence that learning.
Learning takes place even in the absence of reinforcement. The mere exposure to the street allowed the students to build a mental modes of their surroundings, which they later used to quickly find the library. He called this internal perceptual representation of external environmental features and landmarks.
This includes making mind maps, visualization, association, mnemonics, using clues in reading comprehension, underlining keywords, scanning, and self-testing.
Thank you guys for watching. Hope you learned a lot from my video. Bye!